Hello everyone. Welcome to our God's Word Fellowship podcast. I am Vanita Santiago. God is good and His mercy endures forever. Before we get into my message, let's pray. Father, we come into your presence in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Father, you are our good God. You are our awesome God. You are our faithful God. Lord, you're good. And your mercy endures forever. Lord, your good and your faithfulness endures forever. We acknowledge that you are our great God, our mighty God, our awesome God. We give you all the glory, all the honor and praise and worship you, Father. We extol you and we magnify your name. We give you praise, we give you glory, Father. Father, we come into your presence for our country, India. Father, I pray for our local areas. Pray for our city, Madurai, state Tamil Nadu, Bangalore, Karnataka, and all the other states of our country. Father, I pray that you bring us a complete and marvelous restoration for our country, India, from this coronavirus. In the name of Jesus Christ, I bind all the works of the devil, which he is working against our country, against our people, against our economy. In the name of Jesus Christ, let there be freedom. In the name of Jesus, let there be no chaos. In the name of Jesus, the peace of God will work in our country. Father, I pray that you watch over our country to bring peace here, Father. Lord, I pray that you remove all the chaos and confusion that's happening, Father. You remove all the misery, all the pain that people are going through, Father. Lord, I pray that you exchange it with peace and prosperity, Father. We bless you, we worship you, and we adore you, Father. Father, I also pray that, Lord, I pray that you bless the economy of our country, Father. Let there be boom in economy, Father. Lord, I pray that India will prosper. Coronavirus does not have any ability, does not put the economy of our India down, Father. Lord, your blessing will exalt our country. Your blessing will restore our country back to normal, Father. We do not want any third wave or fourth wave. We stop it in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Whatever has opened, whatever has resumed now, Father, in the name of Jesus, will never shut again, Father. Lord, I pray that India will continue to work, continue to function nicely and well, Father. Thank you so much for your blessing upon our country, India. Father, even as we are going to meditate on your word, Father, Lord, I pray that you give us word in due season, Father. Lord, I pray that give me utterance. Lord, I pray that you speak to me, Father, that what I should speak now. Father, I pray that you bless everybody who's going to listen to my voice, Father. Let them get blessed through this message, Father. Thank you so much for speaking to all of us, Father. In the name of my Lord Jesus Christ, I pray. See, we have just finished our another topic where what we were discussing. Fervent prayers bring breakthrough. I encourage you to continue to pray for our country till there is zero cases in our country. God is able and He is mighty. He will do that for us. So on one hand, you continue to pray for our country. On the other hand, I was praying about what message that I should speak this week. God put in my heart to speak about restoration. On one hand, we should trust God for eradication of this coronavirus. On the other hand, we should trust God for the restoration of things in our country. Whatever India has lost in terms of finances, in terms of economy, in terms of market, in terms of any financial area, we should trust God to regain things back to normal. We should trust God in our personal life and as well as for our country. See, for this, I was praying, what should I speak? God put this in my heart to speak about restoration. And the title of my message is God of Restoration. Let's turn to our scripture, to Zechariah chapter 9, verse 11 to 12. As for thee also, by the blood of thy covenant, I have sent forth thy prisoners out of the pit wherein is no water. Turn you to the stronghold, you prisoners of hope. Even today do I declare that I will render double unto thee. See, I want to speak on restoration. So before we get into the restoration part of it, I want to encourage everybody who is in turmoil, who is in the desperate situation. See, these are the times that we have to regain strength in God. We have to regain things. We have to come into that mode of restoration in our life. Because many people have lost their loved ones at this time. I feel so sorry about them. Even many of our relatives also have died in coronavirus. But if they are saved and died in Jesus Christ, that means they are not lost. They are not here. They are shifted from this location to another location. They are there in our future. In our future, we are not lost. We have not lost them. They are found. If they died in Christ Jesus, if they are saved, that means they are not lost. So I also encourage you that they are in your future. Don't be sorrowful about the people whom, if you have lost your loved ones, they are found. I'm not going into that message. I want to focus on only on restoration today. And many people have lost your business, and people have lost, no? They went and borrowed money by paying their jewels, and they have lost their money, lost their business, and many relationships are broken this time. And because all these things have happened in your life, now that you are discouraged and you are beaten down, you are in desperate situation that you are looking for somebody to come to you and help you. Seems like all the doors are closed to you. Everything looks gray and you don't know what to do. Many people have lost things and they are discouraged. And I want you to look to God at this time. Don't lose your hope. You just have lost money. But when you trust God, God will restore that to you. If you have lost your business, when you trust God, God will restore that to you. Hope in God. See, we just read in Zechariah chapter 9, verse 12. Let's read that again. It's a very nice verse. Turn you to the stronghold, you prisoners of hope. What is that, prisoners of hope? What do we read like this here? See, the prisoners of hope means you have to imprison yourselves in hope. How do I explain that? See, it's like this. When you are in the prison of hope, everywhere you look at, you will see hope. On the left hand side, you will see hope. On the right hand side, you will see hope. In the front and back, everywhere you look at, you should hope. That's the meaning of this verse. Is called prisoners of hope. You have to imprison yourself in hope. See, the devil has created a bad situation in our life and in our country. Like, he has destroyed everything. He is the destroyer since the beginning. He comes to steal, kill and destroy. Apart from this, he does not come for anything else. But remember that our Lord Jesus Christ has come to restore everything. See, we read in 1 John, "For this cause the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil." Devil has damaged things, of course, in our country. But you know, God can restore things in our country, in your personal life as well. But you should hope in God. You have to imprison yourself in hope. Everywhere you, when somebody comes with a discouragement words, say, "I hope in God." People may come and tell you, "What are you going to do to pay your loans? How are you going to pay your rent? How are you going to clear all the loans and all the bills that you owe people?" You should be saying, "I trust in God. My God will take care of me." You should be bold now. You have to stir yourself up in the word of God. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. God is willing to help you. God is ready to help you. He is always there to help you. He is the God of comfort. He will comfort you in this situation. See, when we read in Proverbs, there is one scripture where it says, "Hope defers makes the heart sick." When you leave your hope in God, then you will be left with sorrow and discouragement. You see, we have been in both the places. See, in my personal life, if you take, I have been in both the places. There were a time that when I didn't have hope, we had very bad financial situation at 6 or 7 years back. It was not that good, but everywhere looked at in the natural, I was not getting any hope. I was not feeling any hope. The feelings of hope were not at all coming in me. Everywhere I looked at, it was discouragement. It was hopeless situation. Looks like how these things are going to get fixed. But as long as I looked at the situation, as long as I looked at the things outside, how is going to happen, how things are going to fit, try to figure out, try to reason, where is the things coming for us, where is the help coming for us, I did not get any help from anybody. See, I was there in that place. It is very painful place to be in, and I was discouraged. I was sorrowful. Many times I wept and cried, didn't know what to do. But I didn't go around telling people my problems. I told all my problems to God. See, God encouraged me with one verse in Psalm 121. I lift up my eyes unto the hills. From whence cometh my help? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. God is telling the same verse to you today. You lift up your eyes unto the hills. You lift up your eyes unto the God, and your help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. God owns everything. God owns heaven. God owns earth. Everything that what you see, God is the owner. Don't you think that God will do something for us out of it? Don't you think that God will solve your problem? See, the reason Psalmist says that my help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth, it actually shows the authority of God. It shows the ownership of God. Whatever we need in our life is there on this earth. We need money. Money is there on this earth. We need business. Business is there on this earth. Everything that we need, God will provide for us, because He is the creator. He is the owner of this heaven and earth. So look to God. Keep your eyes on God. Don't be hopeless. Even the situation may be hopeless, but trust God. God will change that situation to make look good for you. See, like I said, my example, when I took my eyes off of on the situation and just I made a shift, I kept my eyes on God. And I started seeking God, and I started storing the word of God in my heart, and I began to study and meditate about the goodness of God, the provision of God, the restoration of God. See, step by step, slowly, one by one, God restored everything to me. The first thing that what God restored in my life was my soul. Because my mind, many times I was thinking negatively. Most of the times I had given myself to fear and negativity so much. And many times it would be difficult for me to think positive. Positive thought won't even enter my mind because I was full of negative mind. I was saved. I was a believer for many years, but didn't know how to put my hope in God. Set my eyes on God. See, it was a very bad situation for me, but God helped me. God helped me to come out of financial problems and family problems or whatever it was. Anything that was bothering me, I threw myself in the hand of God. I threw myself in the presence of God. I began to study His goodness and miracles and all the things that He does for the children of man. I decided God will do this for me. Whatever He did for Abraham, God will do it for me. Whatever He did for Isaac, then God will do it for me. Whatever He did for David, then God will do it for me. In fact, if you read John's Gospel, Jesus Himself says, "My Father loves you as much as He loves me." Wow, that's a great place to be in. Listen, my God's children, God the Father loves us as much as He loves Jesus. His love is more than enough for us. You trust God. You trust in His love. Our God is trustworthy. And you keep your hope in God. Keep your trust in God. Bible says, they that trust in the Lord shall never be ashamed. They shall never be put to shame. See, when I started reading and meditating on God's word, hope started rising on the inside of me. It actually started like a seed, little by little. See, it started and it actually birthed and it grew up, and there came a time God brought it to fruition. See, God will do even in your life also. But again, when I say something, no, be consistent in God's word. Be a regular reader of God's word. Be a student of God's word. Have fellowship with God every day. See, He is our Father. He is our living Father and our loving Father. He loves your fellowship. He likes to have fellowship with you. He likes to help you. He wants to talk to you. He wants to give you solution for your problems. God wants to solve your problems more than you want your problems to be solved. God, that's the reason He sent Jesus Christ into this world. See, God so loved the world that He sent His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. Have everlasting life in the sense, it's not only here that we have to struggle as long as we are in this world. We just get saved and then go to heaven. That's a part of salvation. Being saved is a part of salvation. But after that, when you read John's Gospel chapter 10 verse 10, Jesus Christ came to give us life and have it abundantly to the full until it overflows. But if you want me to say it put in simple English words, Jesus Christ came so that you can enjoy your life. How can you enjoy your life when your business is falling apart? How can you enjoy your life when the relationships are broken? How can you enjoy your life when you have lost your loved ones and your discouragement? You can still enjoy when you learn to hope in God. When you learn to trust in God. Make God your refuge. Make God your strength. You have to make that, okay? Because even though God wants to help you, God wants to do awesome things and good things in your life, God is not going to do automatically everything. God wants you to put your trust in Him. God wants you to put your hope in Him. When you hope in God, when you put your trust in God, then you do good things. Whatever He has commanded you in the Bible, your life is taken care of. It's just simple. Do not complicate when I say that trust in God and hope in God. Don't try to make things work in the flesh, in the natural. Do not leave God on this side and then try and go and do everything in the flesh, in the natural. Many times it will be a frustration for you. You know why many people are frustrated and discouraged and still they are in the same place where they are even from decades? It's because people are trying to do things, trying to make things happen in their strength. See, that's when we fall. That's when we fall short of the blessing of God in our life. See, you have to acknowledge God in all your ways. Acknowledge Him and He will direct your paths. When all the doors are closed for you from all the ways, like when you look at outside, there is no hope. Look to God. Look unto the word of God. There is hope in God's word. See, Bible says in John's Gospel chapter 10 again, Jesus is the way, the truth and the life. He is the only way for you to come out of your problems. Keep your eyes on Jesus Christ. He is the only truth that you can hold on. Whatever God has promised in the word is truth. It's the word. God's word is so truth, so pure, as crystal, as clear, that you can trust in God's word. God will never let you down. He is faithful to His word. Whatever He has promised, He is faithful to perform His word. You do not doubt God's word by considering the circumstances. No matter how bad your situation is, maybe you are like living in this crash. You don't have any money in your pocket, but still say, I am blessed in Christ Jesus. I am rich in Christ Jesus, and refuse to say anything out of your mouth. And Bible says, keep your heart and mind in Christ Jesus. Guard your heart and mind in Christ Jesus. Bible says, out of it are the issues of life. So keep your heart and mind filled with God's word. When something problem hits you, when something come and touches you, when something try to squeeze you, you know what should come out of your mouth? God's word. Hope should flow out of your mouth. Hope should release out of your mind. Hope should depict out of your body. That's when like wherever devil touches, you still say, I hope in God. I trust in God. See, that's when you are whipping devil left, right and center. Do not come out of that hope. Stay in hope. Stay in God's presence. Stay in God's word. And God will never let you fail. God's word is truth. It's not a lie. Let God be a true and every man be a liar. Consider that verse in Romans chapter 4, what Paul says. Let God be true and everybody a liar. And also another verse in Numbers chapter 23. I want to finish that my message with this verse. God is not a man that he should lie. Neither is he son of man that he should repent. Whatever he has promised, he will also perform. Whatever he has spoken, his hands will perform. That's our God. See, but God wants you to agree with his word. When you and God agree together without having any doubt, the God's word will come to pass in our life. There are only two things actually, no delay our blessings in our life. It's either us or devil. We are giving too much place to devil. When you correct yourself, then everything will fall in place. We will continue to study more on this subject in the next week. And I hope you got blessed through this message. Thank you so much for listening. God bless you. Jesus Christ is coming soon.